I am white and I have had privilege. Is that a bad thing? Should I feel guilty about it? I don't know. Should I?
People who have privilege, it's incumbent upon them to act in a way which is above the normal standard.
I'm looking forward to working with the hosts of the documentary, which we're calling The Redneck and the Professor, Understanding White Privilege, which we hope will turn into a series covering a broad range of issues. The two hosts are Dane Waters. He's a veteran political strategist from Alabama. He's an author. And then Matt Courtrup is an Oxford-educated man from London who's a political science professor at Coventry University in London. And now here's more about the documentary and the series we hope to develop after the film. Thank you.
I think even though I'm a redneck from Alabama, grew up in Bessemer, Alabama, there are a lot of things I just can't even wrap my head around. And every day I was reading stories about how this is considered racism, or this is because of white privilege, and this is because the so-called cancel culture. And I'm like, what the hell is going on here? So I even started, one thing good about it, it caused me to question my understanding of these issues. What do they actually mean? We look at these issues that are impacting the entire world, both from the viewpoint of a simple redneck from Alabama, and then through the lens of a very learned individual who I have great respect for, Professor Courtrup, and look at both sides of this from both sides of the Atlantic. And also, the COVID is making this a little difficult, but we wanted to throw a little bit of an Anthony Bourdain splash in there. One thing that Anthony Bourdain did amazingly is that he brought people in, personalized it. And it wasn't just about two talking heads. It was about, hey, listen, let's have this conversation with everyday people, hear what they have to say. And it wasn't just an intellectual journey. He did that through food. He did that through experiences. And that's what I want us to do as well with the show.
What I bring to this is a perspective not from Alabama, but from Oxford or and the environs, really, from Westminster. I suppose that is my perspective. But my perspective is also, if you'd like, to take sort of the long view, the philosophical view, for want of a better word, because one of the things that's very interesting when you read the history books and the philosophy books is that racism is a relatively new phenomenon. It is what people in my world would call a social construct.
The thing with white privilege, a lot of people don't know that they have that privilege, right? So if they don't understand they have that privilege, then how can they know that they have to respect it and act a certain way? We have lost the ability. So everything, any conversation that begins, in the most part, is then labeled racist, not racist, sexist, not sexist. The conversations are just so, you can't even have them anymore. And that's once again why this story, not just from you and I to white people having this conversation, mm-hmm. This is why part of this is that I want to include people, real people, you know, people who live this. Yeah.
Who gets to tell the story? Who is setting the agenda? What is the barometer by which all other things are measured by? These are all the tenets of white supremacy and white privilege in America. And we are ecstatic to be working with a group of brave individuals who are taking an iconoclastic approach to dismantling and examining a deep dive of that system.
I can't sit here and say I know what black people go through or Asian people go through or Indian people go through. I can't understand what Meghan Markle goes through. I can't understand what rich people go through. I can't understand what really poor people. I can't understand these because I can only relate to the universe around me and my personal experiences.
Right? Yes, but then you can get what I think Sigmund Freud once says, empathy is the ability to step into somebody else's shoes and then step out again. And I think whenever we're dealing with any issue, we have to have that ability to step into other people's shoes.
Are you saying I'm not empathetic? Is that what you're saying?
No, I think you actually were empathetic just before because you were willing to go out and listen to people. That's why it's important that we go out and we ask people and say, well, how does it feel for you? For me, from the outside, I will not be able to understand totally empathetically because I'm not that person. But I can try to put myself into their shoes. And I think a lot of this racism comes from the fact that a lot of white privileged people think that they have the right to do that. I mean, sometimes we criticize this sort of rights mentality. I have the right to do this. I have a right to do that. Well, you only have a right to do things that do not impact other people negatively.
These are the issues that we must address and we must talk on. And I do think that that's, you know, talk about empathy. I think it's also a responsibility that we have. People who have the ability to get the word out and start the conversation. And this is about, to me, the show is about starting the conversation, not ending the conversation.
What I'm interested in this series is this sort of polarization that we have had, where politics has moved away from policy. We have a saying here in Britain, build a bridge and get over it. And whenever people are complaining about things, and I think I would actually like to build a bridge and get over it and see if I can actually talk to the people on the other side.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Join us.